Hello friends, in previous lecture we see vertex degree. Now in this lecture we are going to study subgraphs. Here G is a graph with vertex set V of G and A set E of G. Let H be a subgraph, H is a graph with vertex set V of H and A set E of H. Then H is called subgraph. Subgraph. If V of H is a subset of V of G and E of H, subset of E of G. G is a graph with vertex set V of G and A set E of G. H is another graph with vertex set V of H and A set E of A. H. Then H is called subgraph of G. Subgraph of G if V of H, vertex set of H, is a subset of vertex set of G and A set of H is a subset of A set of G. G is also called supergraph of H. H is a subgraph of G, then G is called supergraph of H. See here, example, G1 with A, B, C, D. Here A, B, C, D. These are capital A, B, C, D. This is G1, this is G2, and here G3. A, B, C, D. Here, G1 is a subgraph of G2. G1 is also subgraph of G3. G1 is a subgraph of G2 and G1 is a subgraph of G3. But G3 is not a subgraph of G2. G3 is not a subgraph of G2. Now, if H is a subgraph of G, H is a subgraph of G, but H is not equal to G, that means vertex set of H is not equal to vertex set of G, or A set of H is not equal to A set of G, then H is called proper subgraph of G. H is called proper subgraph of G. Now, another definition. If H is a subgraph of G and vertex set of H is equal to vertex set of G, vertex set of H is equal to vertex set of G, then H is called spanning subgraph. Spanning subgraph. Of G. That means H is a subgraph of G, and vertex set of H and vertex set of G same, then H is called spanning subgraph of G. Here, G1 is a spanning subgraph of G3. Here, this G1 is a spanning subgraph of G3. Now, see here, graph of a simple graph. Graph on n vertices. Simple graph of n vertices is always spanning subgraph of complete graph on n vertices. Any graph. Simple, any simple graph on n vertices is spanning subgraph of complete graph on n vertices. Complete graph of n vertices. Now, see here, G is any graph. If G is any graph with vertex set V and A set E, V is non-empty. V is non-empty and V has at least two vertex. That means V contains at least two vertex. Then, for any small v belongs to capital V, G minus V denote, G minus V is a subgraph, by G minus V is obtaining by deleting vertex V and edges which are incident to V, which are incident to V. Then this is called vertex deleted subgraph. This is called vertex deleted subgraph. Vertex deleted subgraph. Vertex set of G containing at least two vertex, then any vertex from G, G minus V is a subgraph obtaining by deleting vertex V and edges which are incident to G, sorry, which incident to V, then this subgraph is called vertex deleted subgraph. Similarly, E belongs to G. E is an any edge. Then G minus E is a subgraph obtaining by deleting एज ई बाय डिलीटिंग एज ई नॉट एंड वर्टाइसेस ऑफ ई ओनली डिलीट द एज नॉट एंड वर्टाइसेस एंड दिस सबग्राफ इज कॉल्ड एज डिलीटेड सबग्राफ एज डिलीटेड सबग्राफ एज डिलीटेड सबग्राफ जी माइनस ई इज एज डिलीटेड सबग्राफ नाउ इट इट्स वर्टेक्स सेट इज सेम एज जी इज वर्टेक्स सेट सेम एज जी नाउ जी इज ग्राफ जी इज अ ग्राफ विथ वर्टेक्स सेट वी एज सेट ई U is a subset of V. U is a subset of vertex set V. Vertex set V. Then G minus U is also subgraph. G minus U is also subgraph. By deleting vertices, all vertices of G and edges which are incident to any vertex of U, edges which are incident, edges which are incident to any vertex of U. Similarly, if F is a subset of E, that means F is a subset of A set, then G minus F is a subgraph. G minus F is a subgraph obtaining by deleting edges from F, edges from F, edges containing F. This is also called edge deleting subgraph. This is also called vertex deleted subgraph. Now, one another definition, that means G is any graph. G is any graph. Then a subgraph obtaining by parallel loops and collection of parallel edges, all edges but one in the collection. This is a spanning subgraph, and this subgraph is called underlying simple graph of G. That means G is any, see here, underlying subgraph means G is any graph. We obtain a subgraph by deleting loops and parallel edges, all edges but one in the collection. Then this subgraph is called underlying subgraph. See here, for example, here G is a graph. V1, V2, V3, V4, sorry, V5, V4, V6. Here, edges e1, e2, e3, e4, e5, e6, e7, e8, e9, e10, and e11. This is G. Now, its underlying subgraphs here, underlying subgraph is here by deleting loops and here V1, V2, V3, here V4, V5, V6, vertex edge same as G. Here delete this loop. Okay, now from these three edges, one edge it is, delete these two parallel edges. Now from these two parallel, one remaining, delete one edge. This is underlying subgraph of G. This is underlying subgraph of G. Only deleting loops and parallel edges. Deleting loops and parallel edges, all edges but one in the collection, all edges but one in the collection. Now see here G minus V3, G minus V3. Now G minus V3, that means delete this vertex and edges incident to V, edges incident to V. That means here vertex are this V1, then V2, now here V5, here V4, and here V6. Now we delete this V3, this edge, this loop, this is also, now this edge and this edge. Delete V3, E2, E3, E4, E7 and E8 edges. We get this is G minus V3. G is this and this is G minus V3. Now, see here, if you take any G minus, suppose E1, that means same as it is, only delete this edge, only delete this edge, we get G minus E1. Now if you take U is equal to V1, V2, then G minus U is equal to G as it is here, V1, V2, that means this vertex here, V3, V5, V4, V5 and here V6. We see. Now see here, that means delete V1 and vertex V2 and edges in turn these two vertex. That means E2, E3, E4, E1, E6 and E5. Now see here, okay, this is G minus U. Similarly, if you take F is equal to E1, E2, E5, E11, then G minus F, that means vertex set as it is, right place all vertex. Only a delete this edges, these edges. See here, V1, V2, V3, V4, V5, V6. Delete only E1, E2. E1, E2. That means here, draw E3. E4. Now, E7. E8. E9. E10. Here, E2. Sorry, E6. E6. Sorry, E6. That means this is a graph G minus F, where F is E1, E2, E5, E11. Only delete 4 edges. Only delete 4 edges. Now, U. Is a non-empty subset of V. U is a non-empty subset of V of a graph G. Of a graph G. Then the subgraph G. Subgraph G of U. Induced by U. Induced by U is a graph having vertex set U and a set consisting of edges of G that have both ends in U. That means vertex set is U. Vertex set is U and a set that edges of G which has both ends in U. For example, see here, if U is equal to G is this graph and U is equal to V2, V3, V5. V2, V3, V5. Then G of U, that means only place V2, V3, V5, V2, V3 and V5 and edges. That means ends, those edges whose ends at this vertex. That means here, here E7 and E8, E7, E8, and this is E5 and E6. This is G by U, G subgraph of G induced by U, where U is V2, V3 and V5. Similarly, if F is a non-empty subset, if F is a non-empty subset F is a non-empty subset of E of G is a set of G, then subgraph G of F induced by F is a graph whose vertex set is a set of ends of edges in F and whose A set is F. See here, if F is equal to graph same as a G, F is equal to, if we take E1, E3, E5, E7, E9. That means draw these edges E1, then E3, E5, E3, E5, E7, then E9, this is the graph G of F, where F is non-empty subset of A set G, non-empty subset of A set E. Now, two graphs. G1 and G2 are said to be disjoint. They have no vertex in common. They have no vertex in common and are said to be edge joined if they have no edge in common. If they have no edge in common. See here, this graph. V4, V3, V1. Here, E3 and E4. This is G1 graph. G1. Now, this graph, E6, E5, and V6, this is G2, this is these two graphs, G1 and G2, are disjoint graphs. G1 and G2 are disjoint graph because no vertex in common. Here, if you take this graph, V1, V2, E6, E2, V3, E7, E8, V4, V6. This is G3. D3. Here G1 and G3 are edge disjoint. There is no edge in common. Here only three edges in G1. These three edges are absent in G3. That means G1 and G3 edge disjoint. Wait, G1 and G2 are disjoint graph. G1 and G2 are disjoint graph. Okay, we stop here.